Good morning, students. So in this semester I am going to discuss you the subject Environmental Engineering 2. In the previous semester we have studied Environmental Engineering 1, which is also known as Water Supply Engineering. So in that paper you have studied the different characteristics of drinking water or potable water and different stages of water treatments. Okay. So in this paper, this is also known as wastewater engineering or sanitary engineering. Okay. So, sanitary engineering, it's a branch of civil engineering which deals with the design of solid waste and wastewater collection and treatment system. It's also known as wastewater engineering. Okay. So, this wastewater engineering is the application of engineering methods to improve sanitation of human communities by providing the removal and disposal of human waste and in addition to the supply of safe potable water. So, this is one of the main branch of civil engineering, that is sanitary engineering or wastewater engineering. So, different portion of this sanitary engineering is discussing in this course. So, in the first module, this is the syllabus for the first module, that is wastewater, sources and flow rate, domestic wastewater, estimation of quantity of wastewater, dry weather flow, storm weather flow, time of concentration. In the second part of first module deals with sewers, design of circular sewers under full and partial flow conditions. So, before going to the engineering aspect, we can have an introduction about the subject. Okay. So in urban areas, that is, we all of you know that water is one of the important source for human beings. In urban areas, for domestic and industrial uses, the source of water is generally reservoir, river, lake, and wells. And out of this total water supplied, generally 60% to 80% contribute as wastewater. Okay, so wastewater means water which is get polluted. So in India, water pollution comes from the main sources like domestic sewage, industrial effluents, leachate from landfill and runoff from solid waste dumps and agricultural land. And in past years, in olden days, the disposal of waste from water closets were carried out manually. And wastewater generated from kitchen and bathrooms was allowed to flow along the open drains. But this primitive method was modified and replaced by water carriage system. And in water carriage system, these waste are mixed with the sufficient quantity of water. Okay. And this waste which is mixed with the sufficient quantity of water is carried through closed conduits under the condition of gravity flow. So this mixture of water and waste product is known as sewage. So what is meant by sewage? Sewage is the mixture of water and waste product. That is, in order to remove these waste products, we are mixing the waste product with too much amount of water. So the mixture of water and the waste product is known as sewage. So in this module or in this course, we are going to discuss about the disposal of sewage, characteristics of sewage, design of sewers, etc. Okay. So sewage is the mixture of water and waste products. So this is wastewater which is collected from a town. So next is the objectives of sewage collection and disposal. So in every town or city, there will be different types of waste, such as waste from bathroom, kitchen, then house and street washings, then from various industrial process, and also semi-liquid waste of human and animal excreta, then dry refuse of house and street sweepings, then broken furniture, then crockery, then waste from industries, etc. And these waste are produced daily. Okay. So if there is no proper arrangement for collection, treatment and disposal of all these waste, they will get accumulated and will create a foul condition, and it will not be hygienic for us. So in addition, the disease bacteria will bred up in the stagnant water, and the health of the public will be in danger. Okay. So all the drinkable water will be get polluted by this condition. So we have to remove all these waste from our town. Okay. So for that we are going to discuss the sanitary engineering. Okay. So the objective of sanitary engineering is, first one, to provide a good sanitary environmental condition of city, protecting public health. Second one, to dispose the human excreta to a safe place by safe and protective means. Next one, to dispose of all liquid waste which is generated from community to a proper place to prevent a favorable condition for mosquito breeding, fly developing or bacteria growing. And last one, to treat the sewage as per need so as not to endanger the body of water or groundwater or land to get polluted but is finally disposed of. Thus, it protects the receiving environment from degradation or contamination. So, in order to achieve all these objectives, we are dealing with the sewage collection and disposal. Okay. So, next we can discuss some of the terms in sewage or in sanitary engineering. So first we can discuss about sewage. So as I have told, sewage means is the mixture of waste and water. Okay. So sewage is water carried waste in solution or suspension that is intended to be removed from a community. Okay. So in order to efficiently remove the waste from a community, we are mixing the waste with water. So that mixture is known as sewage. Okay. So it is also known as wastewater. It is more than 99% water and is characterized by volume or rate of flow, physical condition, chemical constants and bacteriological organism that it contains. So based on that it is characterized and more than 99% of sewage is water. So sewage indicates the liquid waste originated from the domestic use of water and it includes sludge discharged from toilet, urinals, wastewater generated from commercial establishments, institutions, then industrial establishment and also the groundwater and stormwater that may enter into the sewer. That is, in addition to this waste, the groundwater may enter into the sewers, that is in through the pipes. So that will also added with the sewage. Okay, so sewage contains all the waste which is generated from house, industries, commercial buildings, etc. plus the storm water or the rainwater which is entering into the sewer. Okay, and the decomposition of this sewage will produce large quantities of gases. That is, it will be poisonous gases and contains numerous pathogenic or disease producing bacteria along with high concentration of organic matter and suspended solids. So we have to treat the sewage very well in order to make it environmental friendly. Okay. So this is sewage, so which is collected through the channel. Next is sanitary sewage. That is, sewage which is originated from the residential building comes under this category. Sewage from the residential building is known as sanitary sewage. It is also known as domestic wastewater. And this is very foul in nature. It's wastewater generated from, it is the wastewater which is generated from lavatory basins, urinals and water closets of residential buildings, office building, theater and other institutions. It is also known as domestic wastewater. That is the sewage which is generated from residential building. That is known as sanitary sewage. Next is sewage treatment plant. So sewage treatment plant is the facility designed to receive the waste from domestic, commercial and industrial source and to remove materials that damage water quality and compromise public health and safety when discharged into water receiving system or land. So, using this sewage treatment plant, we can make the sewage somewhat environmental friendly. So, we can remove the poisonous gases from the sewage. So, this is one of the sewage treatment plant. Next is sewer. Sewer means it is an underground conduit or drain through which sewage is carried to a point of discharge or disposal. Okay, so underground conduit through which sewage is carried to a point of discharge or disposal is known as sewer. So it is a sewer. It may be made up of plastic, brick, asbestos, etc. or steel sewer. So this is known as sewer. So through this sewer we are collecting or removing the sewage from that point. Next is sewerage. Sewerage means it is the infrastructure which includes device, equipment and appurtenances for the collection, transportation and pumping of sewage but excluding the work for the treatment of sewage. So this is only the device, equipment and appurtenances for the collection and transportation and pumping of sewage and it is not including the works for the treatment of sewage. It's only for collection, transportation and pumping of sewage. So that infrastructure is known as sewerage. Basically it is the water carriage system designed and constructed for collecting and carrying of sewage through the sewers. So that is known as sewerage. Okay. Next is stormwater. Stormwater indicates the rainwater of the locality. Okay, so this storm water will also be added with the sewage. Okay, so storm water, it indicates the rainwater of the locality. Then subsoil water, it is the groundwater that enters into the sewers through the leakage. That is known as subsoil water. That is, if there is any leakage to the sewers, the groundwater may percolate into the sewer. So that type of water is known as subsoil water. Then sullage. Sullage refers to the wastewater which is generated from bathrooms, kitchens, washing place and wash basin, etc. Okay, that is the waste which is produced from bathrooms, kitchen, washing place and wash basin. So is known as sullage. Then composition of this waste does not involve higher concentration of organic matter and it will be less polluted water as compared to the sewage. Okay, so it is only the in the form of water. And this sullage will be generated from bathroom, kitchen, washing place and wash basin. So it will be of a mild poisonous, not as much as poisonous as our sewage. So it is less polluted as compared to the sewage. That is known as sullage. The night soil. Night soil is, it is a term used to indicate the human and animal excreta. That is known as night soil. Human and animal excreta is known as night soil. Next term is sewage and sullage. Difference between sewage and sullage. Sewage means wastewater generated in latrines is known as sewage. And the wastewater generated in bathrooms and kitchen is known as sullage. That we have discussed here, sullage and sewage. And soil pipe means the sewage conveyed through soil pipe. Sewage is conveyed through the soil pipe. And sullage is conveyed through the waste pipe. So that is the difference between soil pipe and waste pipe. This sewage is carried through soil pipe and sullage is carried through waste pipe. Next is wastewater. As you know, the term wastewater include both organic and inorganic constituents in soluble or suspended form and mineral content of liquid waste carried through liquid media. Generally, the organic portion of wastewater undergoes biological decomposition and the mineral matter may combine with water to form dissolved solids. So, that is wastewater. And industrial wastewater means it is the wastewater generated from industrial and commercial areas. It is known as industrial wastewater. That is wastewater which is generated from industrial and commercial areas. This wastewater contains objectionable organic and inorganic compounds that may not be amenable to conventional treatment process. Okay. So these are some of the definitions under sanitary engineering. So this is the introduction of this sanitary engineering, the objectives, and then some of the common terms which have to be familiarized before going to the topic. Okay. So the next topic I will put in the coming video. Thank you.